Appearing before the Committee of Fiscal Infrastructure, which is considering a petition by Kampala City Traders Association, KACITA, challenging the Dicton number plates to be rolled out by government, the Minister of Internal Affairs, Kahinda Otafiire, started by informing legislators that he wrote to President Yoweri Museveni warning him against contracting a Russian company to manage the Dicton number plates after realizing that it was going to shut down a local manufacturer in favor of importation of number plates.
So I wrote to the president and I suggested to him that it would be a good idea if the Russian company worked with the current manufacturers of number plates in Uganda and explored the possibility of putting their chips on the number plates in Uganda.
Otafiire added that the police team, which went to Russia to carry out due diligence against MS Joint Stock Company Global Security that is implementing the project, discovered that there was no evidence of the company executing a project of such a nature anywhere in the world. The police team also discovered that not a single number plate has been produced in Russia, but they were only told that the company is in Poland, which is currently at war with Russia.
That when they inquired about where the number plates were being done, were being manufactured, they wanted to visit the factory, that they were told the factory was in Poland. And as far as I'm concerned, Poland is technically at war with Russia. Ipso facto, every Russian company operating within NATO is under sanctions.
The minister says that if government provides funds to police to roll out the third phase of CCTV camera projects, police will have capacity to do the same work which the joint stock company was contracted to do.
In short, the police says the two systems are incompatible. The police is insisting we should go for the third phase of the CCTV. It would play the same role as what these people are suggesting.
Otafiire added that they have come to a conclusion that the system of Dicton number plates is not compatible with the police CCTV system.
Police tell me there would be complications if we were trying to integrate the two. And I'm not technical. I don't know what complications those would be. But that's what I've been advised by the police.
However, committee members asked the minister to explain how the Russian company got access to the police's CCTV system and if the Minister of Internal Affairs authorized the Russian company to work inside the premises of police. However, the minister denied authorizing joint stock company Global Security to use the police CCTV cameras.
How could these people end up in our police headquarters, use our gadgets without authorization of the ministry?
That the Russians are hacking into our system is what the police reported to me. Said these fellows came with computers and they wanted to enter our system and there was resistance from the police.
Lawmakers expressed concern on the status of Uganda's CCTV project, saying the proximity by Russians to this project exposes Uganda's security system to hacking by the Russian company.
Have you ever discussed this issue in cabinet? If so, what resolution did you come up with?
By law, I can't disclose what we discuss in cabinet.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.